Thursday, April 26, 2012. Welcome to the show. I'm Mike Eckford.
Hi.
I'm Fiona Forbes, and we have a great show coming up for you today. It's our last show before we show you encore presentations for 1 month.
Yeah, for the month of May, and there's a few reasons, one of which is we're doing a bunch of productions here at Shaw TV that you'll see in the fall of 2012, and also we're making some changes here.
That's right. Kid Carson is going to be the new host. No, we're kidding. Everybody's wondering where he went.
Kid
he disappeared from the beat.
This is where he's coming. Yes, absolutely. You won't notice any difference whatsoever. But we're going to change a few things up because we want to involve you.
We want to involve you
in the show. So we're playing with some stuff and we're figuring out.
We're retooling.
But we need a month. But we're also going away on a little bit of a holiday as well. You're going to jolly old?
I'm going to England where I'm going to talk the entire time to my relatives. Well, my family's actually Irish. One of my cousins married a Brit.
Turncoat. Turncoat. That's
well,
what happens.
Well, we're all going to London. I'm actually going to London with my mom. It's a little bit of a family reunion.
And I know there's one thing that you desperately want to take to London more than any other thing. It's not clothing.
Salad. Well, see, the thing is, I love my family, but my cousin Elaine, she doesn't really cook much. Her idea of cooking is going to Marks and Spencer's, and they have it's a lot like Whole Foods, but they have a lot of packaged foods.
Yeah.
And I was there for 2 weeks last time, and on day 12, I swear to God, I hadn't eaten one vegetable.
You got the gout.
And my auntie Valerie said, "What would you like for dinner tonight, Fiona?" And I said, "Well, I'd love a salad."
A vegetable.
And my dear lovely auntie, she what's a salad to Irish people? Potato salad. And to me,
probably with lots of bacon too
and a
ton of mayonnaise.
Oh yeah, my God. Yeah. So I think I'm going to try and smuggle some microgreens.
Maybe that's one of those little cultural barriers. Maybe they call salad something different.
And you don't ask
like
where the bathroom is because they'll think you want to take a bath. You have to ask for the loo.
For the loo. WC, that's the other big one.
My family says the loo, and you are going to go dance on tables at Cabo Wabo?
Yeah, I'm going to go down to Cabo really quickly and do that kind of stuff. But my wife and I'm quite excited because my wife and I are leaving the kids with one of the grandparents, and we're off down there, so it's always fun just to get some time with my wife. Yo, baby, what's up? I don't actually talk like that around my wife, by the way, because she gets like that. She gets quite mortified when I do.
As one should.
Anyway, speaking of leaving your kids behind.
Now, your wife was out of town, and she came back home, and how did it go?
Well, it's always, she travels on business, not super frequently, but every couple of months, she has to go away for a week or so. This was one of those business trips, so she goes away, and for some reason, every time when she comes home, something has happened.
I can't remember what happened last time, but something did happen.
Sometimes it's house stuff, sometimes it's kid stuff, whatever it is. So my wife gets home last night, 12:30, didn't hear her come in. She gets up in the morning. What's the very first thing she has to do? Take her son to the hospital.
What happened to little Wills?
Well, he had an infection.
See, of what?
And it started out as just a little cut. 3-4 days ago.
Miguel!
Well, you're a typical dad,
because dads would say toughen up.
Well, he was playing in a tree fort, and it started out as like a little wound here, and he said it hurt quite a bit, so I put a Band-Aid on it, and then he wanted to take the Band-Aid off, and I took the Band-Aid off, and it looked like he had a little rash from the Band-Aid, right? And I thought it was from the Band-Aid, because he's a kid, he's got sensitive skin. So then the rash got a little bit worse, and I thought, well, I guess the rash from the Band-Aid is getting a little bit worse, and didn't think anything of it. And then apparently when he woke up this morning, it was down onto his chest a little bit.
Is he okay?
He's totally fine. Yeah, it's a very common...
did he have to get his arms amputated again?
It's a common thing for children whose parents don't watch them or care about them. So, no, he's totally fine. It's called lympendago or something like that. And it's a bacteria that everybody naturally carries on their skin. But sometimes if it gets inside an open sore or a cut or anything like that.
When you don't clean the wound?
It can turn
that. You mean when it's dirty?
He was playing in a tree fort.
You mean when there's rusty nails in a tree fort?
What am I supposed to scrub them down after he plays in the tree fort?
There's a little
word, honey,
Michael and I both love. It's called Schadenfreude. It's when you enjoy the misfortune of others.
Yes.
And I have to say, when I heard that Boston was knocked out in the first round, I did a little cheer and I felt a little guilty.
Yeah, because in Vancouver, there has been no joy in Mudville for the last week or so since the Canucks were eliminated from the playoffs. So it has been kind of fun to cast that scowling eye towards the Boston Bruins. And last night, Washington eliminated them in Game 7.
Washington.
Let's just take a second. And enjoy this, Vancouver Canuck fans.
Boston Bruins now turn it over. A two-on-one. Knubel coming with Ward. Knubel with a chance. Backhander loose. They score! They score! They score!
God, somebody over! Get that man some oxygen.
Ward on a rebound. Good morning. Good afternoon.
It's round one, people.
Good night, Boston. The king absolutely is dead. Love it. There will be a new
that guy's going to take off his pants and celebrate.
George McPhee. But do you remember in Vancouver, they slayed the dragon. Like, it was totally the same sort of idea. First round counts a lot. But what that did, sadly, horribly, is it unleashed this torrent of Joel Ward, who scored the goal, a Canadian guy who happens to be Afro-Canadian. He scored the winning goal in Game 7, and the horrible, vitriolic, angry racism that was unleashed by Boston Bruins fans on Twitter
not
is
good.
Appalling. Thousands of different Twitter accounts.
It's 2012, people.
It was just terrible.
Class.
So if you remember, this was the same Boston Bruins fan base that said that Vancouver Canuck fans had absolutely no... We rioted, but we rioted with love in our hearts. You guys
yeah, we rioted out
hatred.
Of love. That's what we did.
We rioted out of...
You know what? At least Tim Thomas won't have to worry about snubbing Obama this year.
That's true, and I don't think he's going to be back with the Bruins next year, so
maybe... It'll be interesting to see, because there's going to be some goalie changes here, I would imagine.
Maybe he could back up Corey Schneider.
Maybe.
That'd be kind of cool.
Yeah. Okay, so Michael, everybody on the show, we get some great guests here, and we always do photos with the guests and stuff, but Michael and I realized...
For our memories.
Not too long ago that we both... Let's do what we do every time we get a picture taken. And every picture, insert guest
looks
here,
exactly
looks
same.
Exactly the same. So we've started a little Urban Rush tradition, which is Michael Eckford, the photo bomber. Just, and I don't ever reference it when I post this on Facebook or Twitter. So here's a couple ones.
Oh, nice.
Yesterday we had Akash the Bloke on and the lovely Aaron Ireland. Where's Mikey? There
yeah,
he is.
There he is.
I have so many pictures like that. Where's Mikey? With Peter Gurgis from
Chihuahua.
That's
one of my favorite ones. I
there
like
he is.
One.
I love it because you're so creepy yeah. and leering.
Yeah.
And I never point this out when I post the photos, but Mike, I think that, you know, because usually the photo bombing is done from afar, like you're behind us. But I think that you might learn something from this photo here, because this is photo bombing
to the
next level. I think we need
ostrich?
To try something new. I think it is an ostrich.
That dude's tripping.
He's tripping balls,
yeah,
Michael.
That
okay,
looks
we have a great nice. Show coming up for you today. But first, we're going to check in with Elise at Rock 101. Here she is.
Hey guys, so you like comedians? I think most people do. Everybody likes to have a good laugh, don't they? Well, Lewis Black is going to be in town at the Red Robinson Show Theater.
I can download 3 million vaginas in a minute. So don't tell me we can't have alternative energy.
And once again, Rock 101 wants to send you there. All you have to do is go to rock101.com and click on the contest page, and there you will find a very simple entry so that you can check them out yourself. Lewis Black, Vancouver, you know you want to go.
Thank you, Elise. Yeah, go and check out Lewis. He's very funny, Lewis Black. And we're taking a break here for the month of May, but of course you can listen to the bro, Elise, Nicky Oman, and myself on Rock 101s every morning.
Absolutely, and you can't listen to me anywhere because I'm going to be lazing about and doing nothing.
Very
actually,
nice.
I'm moving. What am I saying? I'm doing nothing.
Yeah,
I'm moving homes
stuff.
For the first time in 10 years. It's crazy. Okay,
and
we're
going
to take a break.